Now we will see the graphical solution of a linear programming problem. The graphical procedure includes two steps. First is determination of the feasible solution space. Second, determination of the optimum solution from among all the feasible points in the solution space. We can see an example. Jack is an aspiring freshman at XYZ University. He realizes that all work and no play make Jack a dull boy. As a result, Jack wants to apportion his available time of about 10 hours a day between work and play. He estimates that play is twice as much fun as work. He also wants to study at least as much as he plays. However, Jack realizes that if he is going to get all his homework assignments done, he cannot play more than 4 hours a day. How should Jack allocate his time to maximize his pleasure from both work and play? We can see the solution. Let x1 be play hours per day and x2 be work hours per day. Since Jack's available time is 10 hours, x1 plus x2 less than or equal to 10. Since he wants study at least as much as he play, x2 is greater than or equal to x1, that is, x1 minus x2 less than or equal to 0. Since he has to get all his homework done, he cannot play more than 4 hours, that is, x1 less than or equal to 4. So these are the constraints. He estimates that the playing is twice as much fun as work. Hence, his objective is to optimize the fun. That is, maximize is equal to 2x1 plus x2. Hence, the LPP can be stated as maximize is equal to 2x1 plus x2 such that x1 plus x2 less than or equal to 10, x1 minus x2 less than or equal to 0, x1 less than or equal to 4, and x1 x2 greater than or equal to 0. From the graph, red line corresponds to the equation x1 plus x2 equal to 10. Green line corresponds to the equation x1 minus x2 equal to 0. Then the blue line corresponds to the equation x1 equal to 4. Then this shaded region corresponds to the feasible solution space. That means the solution lies in this region. Now look at the corner points. Corner points are 0, 10, 4, 6, 4, 4 and 0, 0. Now we will evaluate z values at these points. Z at 0, 0 equal to 0. Z at 0, 10 equal to 10. Z at 4, 6 equal to 14. Z at 4, 4 equal to 12. Of these, maximum value corresponds to 14. That is at the point 4, 6. Hence, Z optimizes at 4, 6, which means that he has to spend 4 hours for playing and 6 hours for studying. Another method to solve linear programming problem is the simplex method. The use of simplex method to solve an LPP requires that the problem be converted into a standard form, which should have the following characteristics. First one is, all the constraints should be expressed as equations by adding slack or surplus or artificial variables. Second is, the right hand side of each constraint should be made non-negative. Third is, the objective function to be of maximization type. So this is the standard form of an LPP. Optimize, that means maximize or minimize, is equal to c1x1 plus c2x2 plus etc plus cnxn plus 0s1 plus 0s2 plus etc 0sm subject to a11x1 plus a12x2 plus etc a1nxn plus s1 equal to b1. That is, inequations are converted into equations by adding slack variables. Second becomes a21x1 plus a22x2 plus etc plus a2nxn plus s2 equal to b2 etc. am1x1 plus am2x2 plus etc amnxn plus sm equal to bm. where x1, x2, etc., xn, s1, s2, etc., sm are all greater than or equal to 0. Here si's are known as slack variables. There are three types of addition variables, namely slack variables denoted by s, surplus variable by minus s, artificial variables by capital A. These are added in the given LP problem to convert it into standard form of LP model and to convert an inequality to an equality to have a standard form of an LP model and to get an initial feasible solution represented by the columns of the identity matrix. Simplex algorithm maximization case. Step 1 is the formulation of the mathematical model. Second step is the initial simplex table formulation. In the initial simplex table, the first column corresponds to the coefficient of basic variable denoted by CV. Second column is the basic variable, that is V. Third column is the base value of the basic variable, that is denoted by XB. Then remaining columns corresponds to the variables x1, x2, etc., xn, s1, s2, etc., sm. Here, CJS corresponds to the incoming unit profit and ZJ, the value ZJ represent the amount by which the value of the objective function Z would be optimized if one unit of the given variable is added to the new solution. And each of the values in the CJ minus ZJ row signifies the net amount of increase or decrease in the objective function that would occur when one unit of variable represented by the column head is introduced into the solution. That is, CJ minus ZJ denotes the net effect. Step 3 corresponds to the test for optimality. Now we'll examine the value CJ minus ZJ. If all CJ minus ZJ less than or equal to 0, then the basic feasible solution is optimal. If at least one column of the coefficient matrix AK for which CK minus ZK greater than 0 and all elements are negative, then there exists an unbounded solution to the given problem. If at least one CJ minus ZJ greater than 0 and each of these has at least one positive element for some row, then it indicates that an improvement in the value of the objective function Z is possible. In step 4, we will select the variable to enter the basis. If case 3 of step 3 holds, select the column K for which CK minus ZK, that is the maximum of all CJ minus ZJ. The column to be entered is called the key or pivot column. Next, in step 5, test for feasibility. That means we will test the variable to leave the basis. For that, we use the replacement ratio or minimum ratio method. Here we will calculate XBR by ARJ. That is the minimum of all XBI by ARJ or ARJ greater than 0. Column AR is removed and replaced by AK. The row selected is known as the key or pivot row. The element which lies in the intersection of key column and row is known as key or pivot element. In step 6, we will find the new solution and update CB and XB. In step 7, we will repeat the procedure till all CJ minus ZJ are negative or 0. This is the flow chart of the simplex table. Step 1, that is, we start convert LP model into standard form by adding either slack, surplus or artificial variables. Then decide coefficient of these variables in the objective function. Then set up initial simplex table to obtain the initial solution. Then compute Zj and Cj minus Zj values. Now we check the problem is maximization or minimization. If maximization, we will move on to whether Cj minus Zj positive value exists. If yes, we select the key column with the largest positive Cj minus Zj value, and we select key row with minimum ratio. If all Aij less than or equal to 0, then the current solution is unbounded and stop the procedure. Otherwise, we move on to the next step, identify the key element at the intersection of key row and key column. Then update the entries in the simplex table by first obtaining key row values and apply elementary row operations. And we repeat the procedure by computing Zj and Cj minus Zj values. Is the problem is a minimization type, we calculate Cj minus Zj negative values exist. If it is no, solution is optimal. Otherwise, select key column with largest negative Cj minus Zj value. Then repeat the above procedure.